And he lived in the 2nd century after Christ, the Roman period. So I'm making a little pause here. Whatever you get to see around the Acropolis, monuments around the Acropolis, they are all dated at the 2nd century after Christ. That was the second development of Athens. The first one took place in the 5th century before Christ. And whatever we're going to see up the Acropolis, it's dated at the 5th century before Christ. Okay. So Philopappos came here in Athens as all the important personalities of those times did, so as to study with the philosophers. On the other side, you're going to see the Agora with the academies of the philosophers, and because he wanted to thank the Athenians for offering him the chance to be that wise and educated, he constructed that monument. Of course, he made sure that it was at the upper place so as for everybody to see, and to oppose himself to the Romans, that they were occupying the Acropolis back then. But remember that I'm referring to a world where there was no internet or TV, even books, they didn't have books. So if someone wanted to be famous, he had to do things like that. He had to make monuments, he had to finance buildings and things that really needed lots of money to do. So that was a propaganda. At the Acropolis, there were about 30 buildings, for instance, and all around them about 3,000 statues. If they were offers, let's say, the goddess Athena, so a way to thank her for something. But in fact, the most important thing about those statues were the bases of them, where the name of the person giving it to the temple was mentioned, so as to be famous and looked over by other people. We're going to start this path up, so on your way.